The title of the presentation of today is Underground Built Heritage, Cooperative Actions for the Definition of the International Class. It's a matter of fact that underground spaces for sustainable reuse has become a global trend. As it happened, for example, in two international projects, Cost Action 18110 Underground for Value and the bilateral agreement between CNR and JSPS Damage Assessment and Conservation of Underground Space as Valuable Resources for Human Activity Use in Italy and in Japan. In both the projects, we realized that to approach to UBH case studies, to manage projects regarding UBH, and to carry on valorization plans about UBH, we needed a definition for this class, underground built heritage. We needed a classification chart for these elements, and we needed guidelines to address UBH valorization and eventually reuses of UBH. So we tried to answer to these three questions. The first is a definition of an international class, which includes all historical artifacts realized in the underground which have become significant elements of local material and immaterial cultural heritage, and that at the same time had a potential narrative power with reference to selected urban functions within future or ongoing valorization processes. The second step was the definition of a dynamic classification basic chart. The focus of this classification, of this chart, is the analysis of the communication power of UBH regarding selected urban functions. As you can see in the chart, at the center we can have a single system of elements, a single element, or also a country. And the 11 functions are divided in two groups. The first regarding elements which were built in the underground to manage environmental conflicts. The second on the right, which includes all those elements which were built to manage social interaction. Of course, the chart was developed to allow a dynamic analysis. So the passage from one functions in the history to the other in the history of the artifacts. As you can see, those charts can be adopted also for a comparative analysis among different systems of UBH. This is the example that I'm showing you of Italy and Japan. On the left, you can see how all the UBH elements that we analyzed in Italy divided in the functions, and on the right, the same thing for Japan. But always regarding the analysis, the comparative analysis between Italy and Japan, we can also have a comparative analysis of selected case studies. As you can see in different colors, we can underline all the passage from one function to the other in two different systems. At the end, we had to develop a chart for reuse. We selected four levels of reuse which were studied according to different character of each element we are working with. The first level is reinventing, the second is reintroducing, the third is reinterpreting, the fourth is rebuilding. If you need more information about this classification, please see and eventually quote the following article. Thank you.